It's the world's first long-range electric car, costing under $40,000 US, can travel upwards of 238 miles on a charge, more than 300 miles if you're good with your right foot, and is on sale now in certain US markets and South Korea. But while the Chevrolet Bolt EV deserves a place in the history books when it comes to range versus price, this five-seat compact electric car isn't selling as well as some had hoped. What's more, it's being outsold by older, cheaper cars like the less capable Nissan LEAF. So is the Chevrolet Bolt just not priced right? Is Nissan undercutting the Bolt EV so much that people are going for the shorter range LEAF instead? Or is General Motors' lack of interest in charging networks hampering the rollout of this influential plug-in car? I think it's the latter, and I'll tell you next why. Hi everyone, it's Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield here from Transport Evolved, and today I'm here to discuss why I think sales of the Chevrolet Bolt EV are being hampered due to a lack of decent DC quick charging infrastructure across the US, and why GM's lack of interest in supporting public charging infrastructure, along with its policy of charging extra for DC quick charging capabilities on the Bolt EV, it's not helping. Launched at the tail end of last year, the Chevrolet Bolt EV was the first all-electric car to go on sale with a price tag of less than $40,000 US and a real-world range in excess of 238 miles per charge. And after a good month of sales in January, when GM managed a decent number of sales in the launch markets of California and Oregon, sales during February and March have been, well, a little flaccid. Worse still, the Bolt EV has been outsold by the 107-mile Nissan LEAF, which, ahead of the debut of the next-generation LEAF this fall, has been heavily discounted by dealerships looking to get rid of existing inventory. But while some point to LEAF discounts as the reason why the Bolt EV is not selling well, and others, including me, have reminded folks that the Bolt EV is still only available in just parts of the US, whereas the LEAF is available nationwide, I'm starting to think the issue for slow sales lies elsewhere, namely the lack of decent CCS DC quick charging infrastructure and the lack of interest that GM has in helping expand DC quick charging. And the fact that GM charges $750 extra if you want a Bolt EV that can even use a CCS quick charging station. Right now, according to the US Department of Energy, there are some 1,058 charging stations across the US that offer CCS DC quick charging. That's the standard used by the Chevy Bolt EV. There are 1,530 locations that can make use of the CHAdeMO DC quick charging standard used by the Nissan LEAF. And if you're interested, there are 352 Tesla supercharger locations, although I should note each supercharger site, on average, has many more stalls than either a CHAdeMO or CCS site. But what does this all mean? Well, in short, it means there are far less places to charge a CCS-compatible car than there are a CHAdeMO one. And while the Bolt EV can travel a lot further per charge than a current-generation LEAF, the disparity between the number of charging stations means that many prospective Bolt EV customers are simply put off owning one. Why? Well, if there are less CCS quick charging stations than CHAdeMO charging stations, the likelihood of not finding a quick charging station along a specific route or at your destination is higher if you're driving a CCS-compatible Bolt EV than it might be if you're in a LEAF. What's more, there's less chance of redundancy, finding another compatible charging station within easy reach if things aren't working out at the first one as they should. We're creatures of habit. We don't like going out of our way to recharge, and we don't like the idea of being stranded. If there are a few charging stations, even if our car can travel further, we're less likely to want to own it compared to a model that's better supported. Now, I know I'm making massive generalizations here, and I should note that charging infrastructure for CCS cars is catching up to CHAdeMO. So in the not too distant future, this shouldn't be so much of a major issue. But then there's the final issue. While Nissan and many other automakers are proactively supporting the rollout of DC quick charging, investing large chunks of cash to help establish new fueling infrastructure, GM has said publicly that it sees infrastructure investment as part of a job for charging providers and government, not automakers. Which means that while GM will sell you a car, it won't help you fuel that car, something that BMW, Nissan, Volkswagen, and other automakers have been doing for a long time. What's more, these three other automakers and others have been offering customers incentivized free charging when they buy a new car, lowering the cost of ownership dramatically. Own a Bolt EV and you're on your own. paying for charging and hoping that you pick the right charging networks to be a member of. If charging networks were already well developed and widely available, this wouldn't be an issue, but right now it is. Do you agree? Is the Bolt EV losing out because of charging network policy of GM? Or is there some other reason? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And make sure you hit the notification bell so you don't miss a single video. And if you'd like to see more videos from Transport Evolved, please consider supporting me through Patreon. There's a link below and one at the end of the video that you can click. And I'll be back tomorrow with more clean, green awesomeness. Until then, I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield. Thanks for watching, and as always, keep evolving.